Perception is a very key part of thinking. Research by Professor David Perkins at Harvard showed that 90% of the errors of thinking are errors of perception. If you look at things in a certain way, then your logic will produce behavior consistent with your perception. Then there's also a mathematical theorem, Gödel's theorem, which says that from within a situation, you can never logically prove your starting points. Those are perception. Yet we do nothing about perception. We believe that logic is all important. So perception is key in thinking. What do we do about perception? What can we do about perception? Well, if we look at space, we have some directions, north, south, east, west, and we can say to ourselves or to someone else, I want you to look in the north direction, or I want you to look southeast. Now tell me what you see. Instead of waiting for things to catch our attention, we can direct our attention in certain ways. Now, for perception, we can produce similar directions, and that's why it's called direct attention thinking tools, ways of directing attention, ways of directing attention to the consequences of an action, ways of directing attention to the thinking of other parties. All these are specific tools. They're given acronyms like OPVs, other people's views. They're given acronyms because acronyms come to have a place in the brain and can be used deliberately. Attitudes do not. Attitudes you just get used to, but you can't just switch them on when you want to. So these tools, called direct attention thinking tools, can be formally taught and formally used. You can use them personally for yourself. You can ask someone else to use them in a meeting. You can suggest that other people use the tools. A very simple one, the plus-minus interesting PMI, is looking at the positive points, the negative points, and the interesting points, very important. Looking at the consequences, immediate consequences, short-term, medium-term, long-term. And in one experiment, some very senior executives, I asked them to think about a subject, and 86% were in favor. I then asked them to do a CNS, formal tool. 86% in favor dropped to only 15% in favor. And yet each one of them would have said, I always look at the consequences. But doing it formally, deliberately, made a huge difference. So this is a very simple set of tools which can be learned, internalized, and used as required in order to perceive things more clearly, more broadly, and more in terms of alternatives. Direct attention thinking tools. Again, it's a framework, it's software for thinking, which can be used and applied and is concerned with perception. Such a very important part of thinking, such a neglected part of thinking. Perception, direct attention thinking tools.